Hello, everybody, and welcome to another bad game. This is week 3 versus Unny Bunny and the BK Blastoises. Looking at his team, he's got nothing to stop Manetric just vault switching around again by the looks. Obviously, he's not really going to be a vault switches aren't really going to touch either of the Appletons, the Appleton and Diplin. Hit a freeze dryer. Does Warrang get freeze dryer? Probably should have put it on that, thinking about it. That's all right. I was thinking about leading Haunter and just getting a Toxic Spike up, but he does have the rapid spin potential with War Turtle. It still might be nice. He can always Poison Terror on the Diplin though, so I might just lead with the Manectric for a Volt Switch. I mean, I was thinking about maybe Terra Steel on the Claydol is a smart idea here. Because at least it can't be poisoned. It's probably still not going to be outspeeding Typhlosion at plus one here, but Spike Spider, huh? Does bring the Typhlosion in, okay. Do I hide Rapid Ash expecting a fire type move, or do I go into Warrain expecting something else? Either. Let's see. This. I mean, if he goes for like a Shadow Ball or something, that would be awkward, but or a Focus Blast, but getting Typhlosion down low is nice. I'll just go for another high horsepower, see what he wants to bring in, I think. Baton pass could be good. I don't think I want to overthink it. Rapidash has got it done its job by getting rid of that Typhlosion there. That's one less issue for Ninjask. Obviously, I think it was Appleton that's still. That's fair. Say he brings in ursaring. Shit to that, Jesus, Menendrick. If it's the set that it has here, Apple. Diplin, I'm touching a bit more, but not as. Still not a lot. I mean, yeah, he's gonna bring spot ups in, okay. I think I don't try and overthink anything here and just go for the flamethrower. Now, this is where we might have an issue. Oh, I could go back into Zoomies and switch Rua. I might do that actually. I'll flare blitz this. Hopefully I'll die from that. See if this threatens it at all. Yeah, that's what I figured. And this is one issue getting dealt with a little bit at least. Okay, so raw. I gotta look up what this does. What moves does it have? Dragon tail? I remember, does that have minus priority? Oh well, I'm gonna bring Warrain in here. Was Dragon Tail? There you go. Cool. What's gonna hit? Water. Yeah, okay, it is gonna be the sludge wave. That Appleton's still a problem. Ninjas versus Appleton. Did the U-turn do when it was steel type? Nine point 9%. Oh, that was spied ops. Never mind. Ten percent. don't necessarily think it's especially expensive. It's quite defensive, actually. I feel like ursaring is definitely still going to be a problem here. I think it's definitely quite on the physically offensive side. I mean, that would make sense. We're having amnesia as well. Okay, so what is Warrain going to do? A surf. Puts it in range. Warrain verse ursaring. What am I hitting it with most? Ice beam or surf does not matter. Not having sword stance on ninjas this week is kind of sad. Should have just slept talk this thing. Super fanged would have been good. Right. Not great. But I think between Ninjask and Claydol, I can win this. Eight point 9% with Giga Drain. Wait, I'm still type right. Yeah, okay, I can teleport it out. And then. Definitely gonna be interesting. With the toxic spike up, that's really helpful actually though. Well, if you're Dragon Tails, yeah, okay, cool. Are you freaking kidding me? I mean, if you Dragon Tails, Claydol just comes back in. The U-turn was doing 38. So it looks like it's especially defensive. Your wing beat could be the play here, but. All right. You turn out with this thing. Then I can Scorching Sands or even Body Press. I don't think this thing will take me out with Dragon Pulse or Apple Acid. Claydol versus Apple Ton. Scorching Sands or Body Press should put this in range. And Apple Acid. Go for the burn. Because yeah, he's scarfed into this at the moment. We've got four more. Come on, can we get the burn, please? Thank you. And Claydol is going to end up getting the kills here. Alright, he can't recover anymore. Okay, Haunter gets the kill here. And I think Claydol cleans up. No Ninjask kills today. Everything else put in too much work. Good game, Honey Bunny. Thank you for the battle. Well fought. You managed to stop Ninjas getting anything. At least it didn't die, though. But yeah, okay. So my late game plan, I don't know, kind of went all haywire, but I don't know, a different ursaring set maybe could have been much more scary for me, but I'm pretty happy with how I pulled that game together in the end. So yeah, thank you for watching, everyone, and I'll see you for the next battle, whenever that is. Peace.